Tonight, some fascinating insight into the nation's intelligence community from a man who spent decades inside the CIA.
His observations now carrying extra weight as the agency comes under attack by the president. KPIX5's Elizabeth Cook sat down with him in an exclusive one-on-one interview.
John Rizzo has been described as the most influential career lawyer in CIA history, an architect of the enhanced interrogation program. He holds our country's deepest, darkest secrets in the war on terror. In a rare interview, Rizzo sat down with me exclusively to talk about everything from ISIS, North Korea, and Russia's election meddling to whether Donald Trump's tweets could jeopardize national security.
And I learned about it at the same time the American people did.
John Rizzo will never forget where he was the morning of September 11th, 2001.
I was sitting in my office at CIA headquarters in Langley.
Two planes had already hit the World Trade Center, another the Pentagon. The fourth plane was still unaccounted for.
I'll never forget, loudspeakers go off. Please leave, please leave.
The federal government was evacuating, including the Capitol, the White House, and the CIA.
There's nothing imminent, but this is just not the place to be.
The parking lot at Langley was gridlocked from people trying to get out. So he sat down at his desk and grabbed his notepad.
Where you went?
I was on the 81st floor.
I knew the next step would be, well, what do we do about this? I mean, it was an unprecedented intelligence failure for which CIA deserved a lot of the blame. So it was beyond imperative. Whatever it took, you cannot allow this to happen again.
And the people who knocked these buildings down will hear all of us soon.
Those notes became the blueprint from one of the most sweeping and controversial intelligence operations in U.S. history, the Enhanced Interrogation Program, which critics called torture.
We had never undertaken anything approaching this. Time was of the essence. The country, the Congress, the media were demanding in those early days that CIA and FBI do basically whatever it took to stop the next wave of attacks, which everyone assumed could come in a matter of days.
Shortly after the attacks, intelligence agents captured top al-Qaeda leaders, took them to black site prisons where they would use waterboarding and sleep deprivation, among other methods, to get information. The program shut down in 2009.
It is tempting to think we should never have gone down this road, but again, it's so important to put myself back into the times. I honestly would not have made any different decisions.
Do you feel like something like this should be brought back? Do you think that it was effective enough that it could be effective when catching ISIS fighters?
Well, I don't know. It's a simple answer. Al-Qaeda, as you recall, was actually, it still exists, but when bin Laden was still heading it, it was a very top-to-bottom organization, a hierarchy. That's why it was important to grab high-level members of al-Qaeda, because they would know plans for a second attack. With ISIS, of course, it's much harder because the ISIS leadership, via social media, basically incite these rogue individuals, both in Europe and presumably in the United States. They don't tell them what target to hit or when to hit it. It's all self-motivated.
Rizzo was hired at the CIA in 1976. A consistent theme throughout his career, North Korea. Just this week, North Korea test-fired four anti-ship missiles into the sea, their fourth test in a month.
Should we be more worried than we are?
They're making progress. And North Korea is an exceptionally hard target for the intelligence community. And it's incredibly hard to try to recruit agents inside North Korea. It's, far more than Iran, for instance.
I'm like a smart person. I don't have to be told the same thing and the same words every single day for the next 8 years.
President Donald Trump has made it very clear he doesn't trust the CIA.
Do you remember when he once linked the intelligence community and CIA with the Nazis? That is the third rail of political discourse, mm-hmm. to use the word Nazi about anybody or anything.
Sure.
That was hugely damaging to the people, to the morale of the career people at CIA.
Is there fear that with this volatile relationship between this administration and the CIA that ultimately this could affect our national security?
Well, it could. It's corrosive for morale. But, you know, inevitably there'll be this reluctance, if not suspicion, about what the president, again, I'm talking about any president, what does he really think of us? And is he going to ignore us?
This Russia thing with Trump and Russia is a made-up story.
President Trump has denounced unanimous intelligence that Russia meddled in the presidential election. Rizzo says the CIA has known about Russia's election tampering capabilities for years.
They accomplished their mission. So dissent, create confusion, create strife, internal strife in the U.S. political structure. This has been a huge plus for them.
This interview was conducted the day before fired FBI Director James Comey testified before the Senate Intelligence Committee.
Do you believe Donald Trump colluded with Russia?
It's a question I don't think I should answer in an open setting.
Rizzo himself has been in that seat a number of times before, most notably for the enhanced interrogation program.
Keep in mind that the inquisitors here are politicians. And what I saw most vividly during the Iran-Contra hearings in the mid-80s.
The hearing will please come to order.
Politicians, especially when the cameras are on, are not the most incisive questioners. There is a tendency on their part to have their 5 minutes of fame and speechify.
Rizzo retired from the CIA in 2009 after 34 years. He was the 16th lawyer to be hired. Now there are more than 130 lawyers. These days he enjoys watching the drama unfold as a civilian, but he cautions even with the abundance of information and the unprecedented number of leaks, many from the intelligence community, there is always more to the story.
When you're on the outside, you think, especially in this day and age when everything seems to be leaking, that there are no secrets left. But there's still a lot of secrets out there. And, you know, I will take to my grave a whole bunch of them myself.
John Rizzo wrote a memoir about his time at the CIA called Company Man, published by Simon & Schuster, which is part of the CBS Corporation.